MLB Network's coverage of Major League Baseball is on the air. Tonight, Game 2 of this three-game series between the Tampa Bay Rays and the Minnesota Twins. Major League Baseball on MLB Network is next. Kenta Maeda gets the starting nod for the Twins. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, Matt, it's not easy to bunch anything together against this guy. In his last three starts, he has a whip of under 1.10. So we may see some hit and run. We may see some bunting, and we may see some running, because if you want to lay around and try to get hits off this guy, that's not the right thing to do. One of the top pitchers in the game right now.
At the plate, Joey Wendell. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. 2-1 to the Rays leadoff batter. And guys, as we take a look at the Twins at the start of play here tonight, it was another loss for them last time out, and that makes them 2-8 over their last 10 games.
Yeah, Matty, they lost their last game. It was only by one run. They should be able, those are the tough ones, but they should be able to put this one behind them.
Ball even at 2-2. Pitch on the way. Taken high and deep to right. And he's going to make the catch. And he paid a big price for it, too, as he crashes headlong into the wall. So digging in now, Jose Martinez, as you get a look at his current righty-lefty splits entering play in this one. One and one, here it comes. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. And set up working the plate is Matthew Ross, as you see the rest of the umpiring crew there.
Well, D-Row, you better be ready to swing. With Matt Ross behind the dish, big zone.
Yeah, you know, coming into this one, you better pull the trigger. If something's close, Matt Ross is going to punch your ticket.
Bases are empty, one man out. This is in the air out to straightaway center. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now. Now at the plate, Austin Meadows. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. Just hung in there on that one. And the slider is low and inside as he just about got him there.
You can bet these hitters are taking note of what the guy on the hill is working with. A long at bat like this in the first inning can reveal a lot.
Two out, nobody on. And we'll have the first base runner of the ball game here as that misses, and it's a two out walk. So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Brandon Lau, and he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. And it's 1-2.
1-2.
And there he goes towards second. Swung on but fouled off to the left. Meadows leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. To two balls and two strikes now. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. One left for Tampa. The Twins coming up. No score. Ryan Yarbrough will be on the bump for game two of the series. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, this guy's had a solid year up to this point. It's not an easy thing to do in baseball this year with all the high scoring games, but this guy has an ERA of sub three, and that's saying something. If he continues to do that, I think you're going to see a really good performance out of him in this one.
At the plate, Byron Buxton. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. Dan Dero, we take a look at the Rays entering play here tonight. They've had it going the last 10 games. They're 7-3 over that stretch, including a win last time out.
Yeah, Matty. Dan, this team is playing well. They're getting closer in the division race. I guess my question to you, I want to ask you, did you find that you started to really pitch better as the summer months started to get hotter?
No doubt about it. Not only does the team start feeling better, but I think you get a good vibe starting to go throughout the clubhouse. You realize that the schedule is starting to wind itself down. Every game is more important. The bigger the game, hopefully the better you play. And this team's been playing some really good baseball lately.
Digging in, Jorge Polanco. First at bat for him in this one, and he's got that average up over the 300 mark for the year.
There's no way you could have forecasted this kind of season from this guy. Not to take anything away from him, but I don't think many people in baseball considered him to be one of the league's best hitters for average coming into this year.
And he'll pull into second with one away.
And this is just a cut fastball. He's trying to sneak in the back door. He's unable to get it done. Leaves it right over the heart of the plate. And that's just too easy for a guy like this. He's licking his chops as the ball arrives. And he drills it to the outfield for an extra base hit.
Standing in now, Max Kepler. On a rope to the second baseman. And they got there so quickly, the runner didn't get very far from the bag. They settle with just the one out. So the big bat of Miguel Sano digs in next. And he's the right man for the job with runners in scoring position as he ranks fifth in the AL in RBIs entering play.
And he's the best in that category on this ball club, guys. He's the guy they look to bring him home.
The set and the 2-1. Slow roller down the third baseline. But this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Here's the 2-2. Ground ball foul down the left side. The 2-2. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
Now on 3-2 as a pitcher, you've got to go with the pitch that you feel most comfortable throwing with.
And there's a base hit on the line. Polanco rounds the corner and is headed home. And he's safe at the plate as they take the lead.
Hey, that's a big RBI single right there, D-Row. They lost the first game of this series, and they certainly don't want to fall behind and may potentially lose the first two games of this set.
Without question, Dan. Offensively, you're just trying to grind it out, give your team a chance, give the pitcher a chance to relax a little bit, even the series up, hopefully, and fight it out tomorrow.
At the plate now, Alex Avila. Ball three. Eddie Rosario would be next. Sano, the runner at first with two gone. Hit Wheatley back to the mound. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Some more of the colorful characters here at the ballpark tonight. Don't touch that remote. More on MLB Network right after this. All set for the start of the inning, and next to bat will be the first baseman, G-Man Choi. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Center fielder giving chase, and he tracks it down. Nice play for the first out. In now, Willy Adames. And as you take a look at the splits here, he's actually better against right-handed pitching this season. Ball and two strikes to the Rays shortstop. One out, nobody on. Hard hit towards center. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
Danny, I know that's not the execution he was looking for right there. That batter's eyes lit up on that pitch.
Not a real good changeup. One of the things, Mark, this pitcher will do, he'll use that changeup like most pitchers will use the curveball. His changeup is that good. That one wasn't, though.
Ready now, Yandy Diaz. And as you check out his righty-lefty splits, no surprise that he hits better against southpaws than he does against right-handers. Fouled away. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Sharply hit ball back up the middle. In there, a base hit.
A lot of traffic hitting the base pass, first and second with one out. I know you're looking for a double play ball, Dan.
No question about it. I think one of the things you like to do on a pitcher is try to jump on him early before he gets settled in. So far, so good. First and second, looks like a big inning could be brewing.
So now to the plate, Mike Zunino, and it's fouled away. Pitch on its way now to Zunino. Lays off, two and two now. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Working for the punch out and the offering. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out.
That has to make you feel really good as a pitcher, right? You're making pitches all around the zone, and then you bring that one inside. You can't do anything with it. What does it do? It just locks you up inside. You have no chance to put the ball in play.
To the plate now, Kevin Kiermaier. And it's a ball and two strikes to Kiermaier now.
This pitcher's bringing it with some high velo. You better get that front foot down early and get ready, or he's going to throw it right by you.
Adames at second, Diaz at first, two out in the inning. And he'll hang in here as he reaches to foul this one away. The 2-2.
Three ball, two strikes.
Joey Wendell would be next. Out of the stretch, the 3-2 home. And he misses here for ball four. Already two walks surrendered in his first couple of innings of work.
We knew coming into this game that this guy has a tendency to give up a lot of free passes, and history repeats itself as he's already given up two walks here. I'll tell you, effectively wild is a pretty tough thing to be.
Stepping up to the plate, Joey Wendell, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Kepler's there for it. He's got it, and that'll get him out of the jam. Rays leave him loaded. They're down 1-0. Now batting, Eddie Rosario, having a very nice year, currently second in the American League in batting average entering play.
What a powerhouse season, in the top 10 in home runs and runs batted in. He's also one of the most feared hitters in all of baseball.
Ground ball right into the shift. Reined in. And the off-balance throw beats him at first, and that's a tough play. Josh Donaldson digging in now. The 1-1. Swung on and chopped out to the shortstop. Adames picks it up in time to first, and there are two away. So bases are empty here with two gone, and into bat next, the utility man extraordinaire Marwin Gonzalez. Bases are empty here with two men out. Taken, but that catches the inside part of the plate. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. Fielded cleanly. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Down go the Twins in order. We play two innings. It's 1-0. Now at the plate, Jose Martinez, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. 2-1. Popped him up. Gonzalez shading to his right. Makes the play, one away. And with that, we give you a look here at the standings entering play in the AL Central. So the bases are empty with one man gone, and Austin Meadows will be the next to bat. The 2-1 is swung on and missed for strike number two.
Ooh, that's a good pitch to take a hack at right there. Change up in the zone. He'd like to have that one back.
Good eye to lay off the slider there, and he works it to full. 3-2 here.
To be honest with you, I'm a little bit more afraid of the guy on deck than the guy that's up right now. If I'm on the mound, I want this guy up right now. He's the guy that's got to beat me.
Now here's a comebacker back to the mound. And they'll just flip this on to first for the second out of the inning. Striding into the box, Brandon Lau. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Looking to punch him out again, the pitch.
Ball, that's outside.
Lifted down the line and left. And no one can get there. It's a foul ball. The 2-2 one more time. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Buxton is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. Rays go in order. 1-2-3. They still trail 1-0. So striding in, Mitch Garver, and he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. And the 2-1. A bouncer to the left side, scooped up. And a close play at first, but a great stretch that time as they get him by a step for out number one. So one away now in the Minnesota third, and that'll bring up the speedy outfielder Byron Buxton. And he fouls this one off. So far this year against southpaws, Buxton is below the Mendoza line, batting average under 200, unfortunately.
Matty, he struggled this season against left-handed pitching, but maybe a little shot of confidence with the manager putting him in the lineup today.
And the throw here is going to get him at first. Excellent range there at short, and there are two away now. The next twin up are hit Polanco. He scored a run after stroking a double in his first at bat. The 1-1 home.
Hey, after the double in his first at bat, looks like he's trying to pitch around this guy a little bit.
Two out, nobody on. Grounded back up the middle. He's got it. And the throw just does beat him at the bag, so the side is retired. Twins are set down 1-2-3. They lead it 1-0. New inning set to get underway, and that brings up the corner infielder G-Man Choi. And the pitch on 2-1. Oh, and he hammers it to deep right field. Gone! A solo shot here to straightaway right field. Number 10 for him on the year. And with it, the Rays have drawn even at one apiece.
Boy, when this guy gets in a groove, he can hit him, and when he hits him in bunches. Hit a home run in last night's game, and if they continue to pitch him on the outer part of the plate, look out, this guy's going to do some major damage.
In now, Willie Adames. Won't commit on the slider, good patience, and it's full 3-2.
Looked to me like he tried to do way too much on that 2-2 pitch. You don't have to come into the zone on that count, but a pitch that far outside isn't going to tempt anyone to swing.
Now this one's crushed. Left field line. And that nearly broke our tie, but instead it's a foul ball.
He got the fastball where he wanted and just pulled off of it.
Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one.
We know he's probably still thinking about that game-tying home run he just gave up, but I'm going to give him credit for not showing that it's bothering him. When you come back and strike out the next guy, it shows you've still got your head in the right place.
Into the box now, Yandy Diaz. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone. One run on three hits, and no errors for Tampa Bay so far. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. On deck, the big bat of Mike Zunino. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. Pulled high in the air out to left field. And he will run this one down. A good read off the bat for the second out. So bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring up the catcher, Mike Zunino. One run on three hits and no errors for Tampa Bay so far. Fouled off. And another foul ball. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. Struck him out. But the Rays are able to knock things up on the solo home run. Bottom of the fourth coming up, all even at one apiece. Max Kepler the next to grab a bat. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. The 1-1 home is laid off for ball two.
This guy's been really on point so far, but it's not getting any easier. He has to get through 4, 5, and 6 right here.
Sinker, and that's ruled strike two.
2 balls, 2 strikes.
To short. That's through for a base hit, and he's 1-for-2 now.
Hey, after that base knock right there, he's into double digits, D-Row. That's a 10-game hitting streak.
Oh, you talking about double digits, Dan? Now it's getting firm. We're seeing the batting average go up. We're seeing the homers go up. We're seeing the RBIs go up. Everything is moving north.
Into the box, Miguel Sano. Inside and low, 2-1.
Hasn't seen a heater yet in this at bat. One might be coming right here.
Leadoff man aboard here in a 1-1 ball game. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And it's a foul ball. Full count, 3 balls and 2 strikes to the Twins DH.
Well, I'll tell you, he's not hitting over 300 by luck. He really knows the strike zone and his own strengths. That last take is a great example.
Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. The 3-2 one more time. Popped up. Choi has a play. And he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. So a runner at first with one out now. And the next to bat will be the left-handed hitting catcher, Alex Avila. Both clubs with 3 hits in the ballgame. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are 2 gone.
The great equalizer, the changeup. That was a really good job of getting him to offer at that one out of the zone, and it was all set up by the fact that he got ahead of the count and forced the hitter to have to protect. That's the name of the game.
At the plate now, Eddie Rosario. Now a hard liner. Foul. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. Kepler is off of first with 2 away. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
Now this guy's a grinder, fouls off good pitches, and doesn't seem to swing at the ones just off the corner. This guy's a pitcher's nightmare.
The 2-2. Hard hit ball to second. And the inning will continue as that's through for a 2-out hit.
Boy, after that base knock right there, D-Roll, he extends his hitting streak to 7 games.
Yeah, and you can tell he's made some necessary adjustments at the plate. Anytime you're getting a knock every day of the week, you're doing things right. He's keeping that front shoulder tucked, staying inside the ball, not trying to do too much.
Set and the 2-1. Two men are on with 2 men out. Cutter, and it doesn't make it back. 3-2.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Here's the payoff pitch down the third baseline. A dive, but he can't knock it down. It's through for a base hit. And the runner from second is in to score. And now time is called here as their pitching coach is going to pay a quick visit to the mound to discuss how they want to attack things here. So now to the plate, Marwin Gonzalez. 3-1. Ready with the 3-1. And a full count now, 3-2. Bouncer up the middle. Oh, and he can't come up with it.
Boy, you know, D-Row, every pitcher loves that. Shortstop does a great job just to knock that ball down to keep it from the outfield, to keep that runner from advancing all the way to home.
Yeah, and as a former middle infielder, Dan, we love this stuff. This is what gets you jacked up, trying to save runs for your pitcher, give you another chance to execute and get us out of this inning.
Standing in now, Mitch Garver, hit down the line at first. Fielded cleanly, throw to first in time, and the big inning is avoided as the side is retired. Twins forced to settle for one. On to the top of inning number five we go. It's the Twins 2, the Rays 1. Welcome back to Target Field as we send it to Heidi Watney.
Matt, Rays manager Kevin Cash talked to me in between innings about his lineup's offensive production. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. He said the high pitch count they've run up is a result of a lot of great battles at the plate by his guys, and he's not wrong. So far, they've worked 5 full counts in their at-bats.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Randy Dobnik, a 6'1" right-hander, will be the one to get the call from the bullpen here. Ready to go in the top of the fifth, and that means Kevin Kiermaier will hit next. Now the payoff pitch home, and a good eye here as he takes ball 4, and it's a base on balls to lead off the fifth inning.
He's really struggled with his command in this game, no doubt about it, but to make things worse, he just lost one of the fastest guys in the ballpark.
Back to the top of the order now, and digging in next will be Joey Wendell. And that fastball's too much for him there. 1-2. Couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Look out, that one almost got away from him. 2-2 now. Now a throw over, and the runner back easily. Fifth inning, 2-1 our score. Grounder down the line at third. But a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. Protecting with 2 strikes, went out of the zone that time, but he stays alive. Full count, 3 balls and 2 strikes to the Rays DH.
Gotta believe that runner from first is gonna be in motion, especially in this situation. As an offensive player, just hit something hard because those defenders are going to be moving.
Here comes the payoff pitch. Popped him up. Garver is under it. 1 out. So a runner on first with 1 out now. And up next will be the right-handed hitting Jose Martinez. Liner toward right center. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second, as there are two aboard now.
Outside of home runs, nothing fires me up more than watching a good baseball player drive the ball to the opposite field. Talking about hitting the inside half of the baseball, that's exactly what happened right there. And when we say inside half of the baseball, imagine the ball coming to a complete stop halfway between home plate and the pitcher's mound, and then cutting that baseball in half and highlighting the inside half. That's where you're trying to take the knob of your bat or the hands to that spot and carve the inside half of the baseball with power.
Ball three. 3-2 now.
Hey, they tried to tie him up on that last pitch, so I like that they went away with this one. The execution didn't work, but I like the idea behind it.
Now the 3-2 pitch. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Center fielder going back. On the warning track, he makes the catch. And he'll make it up safely to third, so they're at the corners now with two men out. Up next for the Rays, Brandon Lau. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. 3-1, here it is. Hit hard to the right side, but foul. And he hammers it to deep right field. But that'll stay in the park as it's off the wall.
When this thing left the bat, I thought it had 3-run homer written all over it. But it bounces off the wall, so only one run scores. And now a chance for his buddy to return the favor and bring in one or maybe two.
In now, G-Man Choi. 3-1.
This is a spot you like to be in as a good hitter. Runners in scoring position and count leverage in your favor.
Out of the stretch, the 3-1 home. And he misses with it for ball four. So the bases will be loaded now with two away.
Right about now, the manager's questioning his decision to bring this guy in. If you can't trust a reliever to throw strikes, you can't trust him at all. We'll see if he comes to get him sooner than later.
So stepping in, Willie Adames. He's 1-for-2 in this one. Martinez on third. Lau over at second. Choi on at first with two down. This is on the ground to short. Is he going to get out of this? He is. They get the force at second base, and the inning is over. A run for the Rays thanks to the RBI double. Bottom of the fifth coming up, and we're deadlocked now at two apiece. Welcome back to Target Field as we send it to Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. In between innings, I was able to catch up with the manager of the Twins to discuss his thoughts on Minnesota's lineup so far. And he was very pleased with how little they're swinging and missing right now. He said he's really proud of the fact that they've only gone down on strikes once in the game, all while averaging over a base hit per inning. If that kind of combination continues, he thinks there's a lot more to look forward to.
Thank you, Heidi. Brendan McKay, a 6-foot-2-inch left-hander, jogs in to take over on the hill. Bottom of the inning now, and next will be a speed thread in the form of outfielder Byron Buxton. The 2-2 gets him swinging. He struck him out.
Wow, that's awfully impressive right there. The pitch before was really close. Called the ball. What does he do? He comes back with a better pitch and gets the punch out.
To the plate now, Jorge Polanco. Close there, but he doesn't get the call with the breaking ball. Bases are empty, one man out. Started to chase that time, but then he wisely holds off for ball three. The 3-1 is in there for the second strike. Now the payoff pitch home. Hit out towards second. It's flagged down deep in the hole. And an off-balance throw is in time as he takes one away. Wow. So two are gone in the Twins' half of the fifth. And that'll bring up the outfielder, Max Kepler. Now the 1-1 pitch. Lifted down the line in left. Diaz in foul ground. And this will fall, but it's a foul ball. The 1-2.
I got to count 2-2.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Now a swing and he gets him to pop it up. Diaz in foul ground, but this will land untouched. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. He got him. Lively fastball that time, and it puts an end to the inning. Down go the Twins in order through five, all even at 2-2. Tyler Duffy takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and set to go is the third baseman, Yandy Diaz. Now the 2-1. Back up the middle and in for a base hit.
Hey guys, I like the execution by the batter there. He got a hanger in the middle of the plate. He could have come unglued, but he didn't. He stayed focused and drove a line drive base hit.
Into the box, Mike Zunino. Loud contact off the bat of Zunino, and a ball sent to deep left field. But a foul ball.
I think for every player, for every former player, that swing right there is the reason we need to extend the netting without question. Want the fans to be safe.
And that'll get by and on through towards the wall. And they've really got something going here. Runners at second and third to start the inning.
The good news for pitchers in this park is that it doesn't give up many home runs. A lot of room in the outfield. Sometimes that's the bad news as well, though, because there's a lot of space for hits to get down and to go for extra bases just like that.
Into the box now, Kevin Kiermaier. Now about a 58-foot breaking pitch that he wisely lays off here. Some movement now in the Minnesota bullpen as a right-hander's up and throwing. Couple of men in scoring position here with none down. Line drive base hit to right, and the run is in to score from third. It's a 3-2 ball game.
Boy, that has to feel good as a hitter, D. Where you get that base hit to give your team the lead, you have to feel good when you get down to first base.
Yeah, it's just a nice approach. You see him turn to his boys right there and get fired up with the dugout. 100%, not trying to do too much, able to quiet the moment down, center himself, and come through in a big spot.
So now to the plate, Joey Wendell. Runners at the corners here, nobody out. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two.
Props to the hitter right there for laying off with a guy on third. You want to be aggressive, but you have to get a pitch you can drive.
Looking for the K. Here's the pitch. And this is on the ground to short. Could be two. On to first, and it's a double play, although the run does come into score from third.
Really good pitch from the pitcher right there. Down in the zone, hits on top of it, induces the ground ball double play.
standing in, Jose Martinez. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. Too high, ball three.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Swung on and hit pretty well out to deep left field. And that'll get down out there for extra bases. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
Left fielder really never had a chance at that one at all. It was over his head before he knew it, bouncing off the base of the wall for an easy double. Those are the kind of shots anyone would feel good about.
Standing in now, Austin Meadows. Hit softly down the line at first, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Working for the punch out and the offering. Now a fastball as he just reared up and let that one fly, and the inning is over. So it's two runs on four base hits, no errors, and one man left on. To the bottom of the sixth we go. 4, 5, and 6 coming up. The Rays 4 and the Twins 2. Here's Miguel Sano. He's 1-for-2 in the ballgame.
Things not looking very good so far in this one, but we're still in the middle innings. They're down by a couple of runs, and this would be the right place and the right time to get something going. The last thing they want to do is to try to come from behind and win this one in the 8th or 9th inning.
High and deep down the left field line. And this is going to get down. It's a foul ball. The 1-2. There's a fastball that misses.
Wow, that was a close pitch on 1-2. The count's now at 2-2, but boy, that one very easily could have been called strike three. Really close pitch.
Looks at a fastball low here, and it's full. 3-2.
And in a two-run game right here, you really don't want to walk the leadoff guy to start an inning. You've got to keep that tying run in the on-deck circle as long as you can.
Now the payoff pitch home. And that one misses, so the leadoff man will head down to first on ball four to start the bottom of the sixth. Ready for another chance? Alex Avila. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, Matty, big time K last time up, and it's been a tough series for him so far. You can tell he's just not seeing the ball off this team. Let's see if he can make an adjustment right here.
Sano on at first, nobody out. Got him. So he's down on strikes for the second time here tonight.
Well, his struggles continue. It's been a rough go of it at the plate with him, and watching this at bat, it's clear to me that his rhythm and timing, they're just all off. Even as a pitcher like I was, you could tell these things and exploit them.
Stepping in now, Eddie Rosario. Strike two as that's taken on the outside part of the plate. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Kiermaier's got a read on it, and that's the second out of the inning. So striding forward now, Josh Donaldson, 1-for-2. He grounded out first time up and followed that with a base hit. The 3-1. And a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away.
Oh, man, I think this walk is going to grind at him for a bit. He just missed, and now the inning continues with a man in scoring position.
Here's Marwin Gonzalez now. We'll see if he can come through in a clutch spot here. Two on, two out here in inning number six. Now a ball swung on and heading for the stands in right, and that'll move the count to 1-2 now. against left-handed pitching so far this season, Gonzalez brings a batting average just a little over the 250 mark. 2-2.
He's already walked two in this inning already. This guy just can't seem to find the strike zone.
Action in the Rays' pen now as they've got a lefty and a right-hander up and throwing. Two down, runners at first and second. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And nearly a three-run shot. Instead, it's a foul ball. Now a fastball swung on and missed, and that is out number three. A couple of walks, but no damage. More baseball on MLB Network right after this. Tyler Clippard is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven. Seventh inning ready to roll, and standing in is the power hitting second baseman Brandon Lau. Fouled away. Ready on 1-2. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
Well, there's the great equalizer, the changeup, El Cambio. Listen, if you can keep that pitch in your back pocket and pull it out when you need it, like he did right there, usually hitters, they don't stand a chance.
In now, G-Man Choi. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. Seventh inning here at the ballpark, 4-2 our score. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Sliced hard on the ground. Donaldson's up with it. Throw on to first will get him. Scored at 5-3 on the putout, though it looked more like a 6-3 ground ball. Nevertheless, there are two away now. Coming to the plate now, Willie Adames. In past history against Tyler Clippard, he's a 333 hitter. Swinging a blooper to the right side. In comes Kepler, but he won't get there. It falls in.
Boy, this guy's been swinging a hot stick lately, and there's just another example. And even when he doesn't hit one on the barrel, he still manages another base hit.
Yeah, don't overthink it. When you're flowing like he is right now, he's hot as a pistol. Everything's falling.
At the plate, Yandy Diaz. And the pitch misses low and away for ball two. And that's in there above the belt, so it's even now, 2-2. Adames leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. Now a swing and a bouncing ball for the shortstop, Polanco. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Rays strand just the one as they can't add to their 4-2 lead. Diego Castillo gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh. Now in the box, Mitch Garver. He was retired via the ground ball last time up.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast? They could certainly use that right now.
One and two to the Twins catcher.
That's just too much velocity upstairs to get good wood on it. It's going to have to lower his sights.
And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2.
Yeah.
Now the pitch. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first down.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and it backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
Into the box, Byron Buxton. He'll try to bunt his way on as he gets this one down. Throw to first will get him as they pounce on it quickly to snuff out the bunt attempt. Digging in the switch hitter, Jorge Polanco. Two out, nobody on. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Not surprisingly here, this is on the ground to the right side. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Twins are set down 1-2-3. Still down by a count of 4-2. Corey Guerin has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. Ready to begin the eighth, and that'll bring up the catcher, Mike Zunino. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. Guerin was known as a short relief specialist, a guy who came in, got one or two big outs, but with the new pace of play rules, they're forcing a change for this right-hander. Now the 2-1 pitch is a sinker that misses for a ball.
You do not want to walk the eight-hole hitter. It just opens up so many options. Do we bunt him over to second with the nine-hole hitter? Do we try and play for that big rally with the top of the order coming up? This is a huge pitch. You can't allow this guy to walk.
A swing and a drive to center field. That one's got a chance. And he's going to make the catch on the warning track. A fine running play there for the first out. Digging in to try it again, Kevin Kiermaier. He came through with an RBI single in his last at-bat. The set and the 1-1 pitch. Right-hander starts to loosen out in the bullpen now. One out, nobody on. Drops one down here, and he'll try to beat it out. And he will not have a play behind him. It's an infield single. To the plate now, Joey Wendell, pulled toward right center field. Buxton is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. Stepping in, Jose Martinez. He's doubled and singled in four at-bats in this contest. Getting late, 4-2 our score as we play the eighth inning.
He's going,
Kiermaier's
he's
running.
Going.
Pitch inside, the throw is well behind the play. That's an easy stolen base.
It was pretty obvious he would likely be on the move with two outs, and I'm sure the defense knew it too. But he has lightning speed and was able to take the bag anyways.
Here's a shot to right field, and that's going to be in for a base hit. And this will add on to their lead. It's now a 5-2 ball game.
Hey, Dero, that's a big RBI right there to stretch this lead to 3. Takes a lot of pressure off your pitcher going into the bottom part of the inning.
Yeah, Dan, no doubt. As an offense, all you're trying to do is put your pitchers in positions to be successful. Giving them that 3-run cushion has to make you feel good.
At the plate now, Austin Meadows. And, oh, that should have been ball four there, but it's a called strike, and that runs things full at 3-2.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Now the payoff pitch home. And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
Man, that's just painful for a pitcher right there. A 3-2 offering that was right on the corner, but he couldn't get him to chase, and he doesn't get the call. Can't beat yourself up about that one too much.
So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Brandon Lau. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
High in the air down the right field line. And foul. He's set. Here's the 2-2. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. Rays will settle for just the one. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the eighth coming up. The Rays lead it 5-2. Jose Alvarado is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth. Striding in, Max Kepler. He went down on strikes last time up.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Skied into straightaway right. Meadows moving back. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. Now it would be the Minnesota DH, Miguel Sano. His career numbers against this pitcher, not a big sample size, 0-1. Here's the 1-1 pitch.
Got to find a way to scratch at least one across. You do not want to take on the monster closing the game down three.
Now the 2-1 pitch. Will not catch the zone, ball three.
Three ball, one strike.
The 3-1. And that's outside. He lost him, ball four.
Whoa, you know a pitcher is really fighting himself when he misses a zone by that much. I'm surprised the catcher could even bring that in.
So a runner at first now with one away. And the next to bat will be the left-handed hitting catcher, Alex Avila. And he misses again. Ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball.
Two ways to look at this walk. If you're the hitting coach, you say, that's a great AB. Down 0-2 and you work the walk. But if you're a pitcher like me, that's just a case of letting a guy off the hook, and that can really frustrate you.
Ready once again, Eddie Rosario. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Checked his swing there, and did he go? No, he did not, says the third base umpire, so it's ball four.
He almost got him to commit there. As we take another look at it in slow motion, he comes awfully close to breaking that plane, but he was able to hold back. Strong wrist, and he gets a trip to first because of it.
So bases are loaded. Nowhere to put him with one away. And that brings up the former American League MVP, Josh Donaldson. And it's fouled away. Sano at third, Avila on second, Rosario at first, one gone. Now a curveball misses inside. He's set. Here's the 2-2. And the curveball bounces here, but a good job behind the plate to keep it at arm's length. From the stretch. And that misses. Ball four. A run will come in to score.
And it's times like these that a pitcher feels awfully lonely. I can see why he didn't want to be too aggressive. Last thing he wants to do is give up a grand slam to a dangerous hitter, but walking in a run is painful too. And here he is again, still with the bases loaded.
Oliver Drake was called upon to pitch, really needing that double play ball. Bases are loaded here with only one man out. Jimmy Kerrigan will come on now and pinch run here. Marwin Gonzalez will be the first one to greet him here as he'll be forced to turn around and hit from the left side now. Crowd gets up for the 3-2. Oh, it's on the ground to second. Did he get his double play? On the first, and talk about doing the job out of the bullpen. One batter, two outs, and the inning is over. Twins forced to settle for one. Ninth inning coming up. It's the Rays 5 and the Twins 3. Jimmy Kerrigan remains in the game, batting ninth and manning left field. Trevor May enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. All set to start the ninth in this one, and that brings up the corner infielder G-Man Choi. They haven't played perfectly as it's hit on the ground. Gonzalez is there, and a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out. Stepping in, Willy Adames. He's 2-for-4 in the ballgame. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. Gone! Solo shot here to left, number 10 for him on the year, and it's now 6-3.
They still have the bottom of the ninth to try and stage a comeback, but one thing that's not coming back is this blast to extend the lead to 3. Nice knowing you've got some room for error, especially on the road.
So now to the plate, Yandy Diaz. And he finds a way to catch the zone here. It's 1-2. Action in the bullpen now as a right-hander begins to throw out there. Bases are empty, one man out. Yanked the slider across that time, laid off for a ball.
Going to need to make a little bit of an adjustment with his slider release and at least tempt the hitter that it's going to be a strike.
And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2. Heading out towards shallow right. Kepler's there for it. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. Ready for another shot now. Mike Zunino. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day. Two and one. Bases are empty here with two men out. Now a swing and a bouncing ball for Donaldson at third. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. Rays tack on one more thanks to the solo home run. Last chance coming up here for the Twins. It's the Rays 6 and the Twins 3. Nick Anderson takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to close the door. Now at the plate, Mitch Garver, who could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far.
Hey, not impossible, but highly improbable. Even when you're at home to score 3 runs off a closer like this guy, they've got the work cut out for him.
No offer on that one. 2 balls and a strike. And this is on the inside edge, perhaps off the inside edge, but it's a called strike. 2-2 now. Never tempted to swing at that ball down low. It's ball 3.
It'd be great right here if he was able to work himself on base. You got the leadoff hitter on deck, and you know the middle of the order is coming up right behind him.
Crowd gets up for the 3-2. Sent on the ground, but right into the shift. Throw to first is in time for the first down. So the leadoff man gone to start the top of the ninth as we take a look at league saves leaders entering play. And as you see, he's right up there among league leaders in that department. Here's Byron Buxton now, struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0 for 4 ball game right here. Three balls and 2 strikes to the Twins center fielder. One out, nobody on. And he looks at ball 4 now, so he's aboard, and you always have to worry about the threat of the steal when he's on base. So a runner at first now with 1 away, and that'll bring in Jorge Polanco to hit next. And this one's up around the eyes, 2-1. Has a look, now the pitch. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. Buxton is on his way home. He comes across to score as they now trail by only 2. Well, partner, this one might not be over yet as the lead has shrunk to just 2 now as they continue to chip away at this deficit. Digging in, Max Kepler. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Set and the 2-1 pitch.
Hey, this isn't going to be an easy save. These guys are making them work for this one.
He's set and the payoff pitch. He is swung on and missed. He got him.
Well, this pitching staff has done a pretty good job right there. That's the 4th time he struck out, and we're only in the 2nd game of this series.
Into the box now, Miguel Sano. Now a swing and a fly ball. And it's a foul ball. Final strike for the Twins. off the plate that time and a little high. It's even at 2-2.
You know, in this situation, you almost have to pitch like there's no one on base. That run really doesn't mean anything with the lead they've got. The hitter is the guy that can turn this game on its head.
Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. And he strikes him out to end it here as they were able to get the possible tying run to the plate but could not cash in.
Yeah, he does surrender one run. So it wasn't a flawless performance. But in this game, you don't have to be perfect. You just have to be good enough to win. And he was.
A 6-4 finish in tonight's affair. The Rays rode an important sixth inning to victory in this one. Brendan McKay earns his third win of the year in relief. Nick Anderson hammers down the save, his 20th of the season. So that'll put a wrap on things here this evening. For my partners Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. This has been a special presentation of MLB Network. Good night, everybody.